When Leica introduced a few months ago the new Leica M10 monochrome with 40 megapixels black and white sensor, it was kind of foreseeable that they will also upgrade their Leica M rangefinder series cameras with a higher resolution sensor. And that's what happened about 2 days ago. They went live with an announcement that the Leica M10R is the newest member of the Leica M family here. I have it here in front of me. And clearly this is something I was super curious to get my hands on. So I'm super happy that I have the new Leica M10R already with me and had the opportunity to shoot with it for the last 5 hours. And I also have it with me tomorrow on Sunday. And I'm very grateful to my friends from the Leica store in Zurich, in particular Ivo, who made this possible. And they are typically not renting out camera equipment, but they just left this one with me for the next 1.5 days, which is super nice. And so I can get my hands on the camera and see what it is. And actually, after 5 hours spending time with the camera, my conclusion is pretty short. It is a Leica M10P with a higher resolution sensor. Everything else seems to be the same. And that's perfect, because the Leica M10P, in my opinion, is the best rangefinder camera the world has to offer. And giving that rangefinder camera a higher resolution sensor, that's just the right thing to do. And since these Leica lenses here typically are constructed from their optical properties to actually also deal very well with higher resolution sensors, like we saw on the, for instance, M10 monochrome, or when you have the M to L adapter and use these Leica M lenses on the Leica SL2 with 47 megapixels. I did this many times. There are many reviews on my channel where you can look this up. And these lenses, from the optical properties, they are very well capable to deal with higher resolutions than the original native 24 megapixels, which were built into the Leica M series rangefinder cameras. So there is absolutely no problem. It's just, you know, a continuation of a very successful story. And now here we have it, the Leica M10P with a 40 plus megapixel sensor. I say 40 megapixel plus because I think the exact resolution is a little more than 40 megapixels. And even the name of that new beast is very natural. So when I said this is a Leica M10P with a 40 plus megapixel resolution sensor, they just call this new camera Leica M10R, and R stands for resolution. Very natural, just the right thing to do, I think. And given that we have an M10 monochrome with 40 megapixels and a Leica SL2 and Leica Q2 with 47 megapixels, makes a lot of sense to me. So I'm sitting outside for that little video here because I want to catch the last daylight of today. But it's getting late. If I look at my watch, we have 9:30 p.m. and there's still enough light to do that little review before I want to post it tomorrow morning. So when I say it's a Leica M10P, it is a Leica M10P, just a higher resolution sensor. If you look at the elements on the body here, all exactly the same. So here's the shutter speed or exposure time. It's the same setup as you know it from the M10P. Here is the on-off switch and the shutter button. Everything the same. Here is the ISO wheel. You can pull it up and then you can adjust it. And then when you push it down, it's securely locked here, so you cannot accidentally turn it to some setting which you don't want. You have the rangefinder here, which is the same as on the M10P. You have the three buttons, which we know from the former camera. We have the joystick setup here and the thumb wheel. That's all the same. And also from the front side is exactly the same, appearance than what we know. And even the, I would say, the grip here and the texture we have on that body is very nice. It comes in a chrome finish as well as in a black finish, and this one is obviously the chrome finish. Looks very nice, but also the black finish looks absolutely elegant in my opinion. And here's an important button I'm going to explain in a moment. That's maybe the most important button if you care for long exposures, but everything you see on that camera is very familiar, very minimalistic, and to some extent completely helping the photographer to focus on the image and not getting distracted by too much technology or, you know, elements on the camera. Now if you switch that camera on, we have in the same way the look as we had it before. Let's get the lens hood off here, And if I go into the menu, you have your favorites page. That's the same you have on the M10P. You can customize this. For instance, if you go into the main menu and then you go here through your pages and you go to customize control, you can edit your favorites. And then you see what I change here from off to on will appear on the favorite page, which is the first page which appears when you press the menu button. And then here you have the main menu. And in the same way as before, by pushing the menu button, you can scroll page by page through your settings. And again, it's very minimalistic. It's what needs to be there, but nothing unnecessary. So we have lens detection here, drive mode, which I have in single shooting. We still have an intervalometer here. That's the same as in the M10P. I really like that. You have exposure bracketing, which is also good. And I used it already today just to test it out. And you have your metering where you can go spot, center, weighted, multi-field. That's all the same. Exposure compensation. ISO setup. If you go to the maximum auto ISO, this beast goes up to 50,000 of ISO, which is huge, but something we've seen before on Leica cameras. And I typically keep this at 12,500 here. You can also give your maximum exposure time here by the rule of thumb, 1/1 focal length. All these kind of things. White balance, file format. I typically have RAW, means digital negative, and JPEG. We have here the JPEG settings. Now this is new. The large is now not 24 megapixel, but 40 megapixel. Everything else is exactly the same as we know it from the M10P. Capture assistance, I typically use focus peaking and all of that. I don't like histograms because I can deal with it without histograms. But anyway, it's all the same. It looks so familiar because, as I said before, I repeat myself, it's an M10P with a higher resolution sensor. So you have all these settings here. You can basically connect it to the Leica Photos app and then use the Leica Photos app to remotely control your camera or to transfer images very quickly from the camera directly after the shot onto your smartphone or your iPad. That's all the same. And in general, I think a very familiar package, just with a higher resolution sensor. So I like a lot what I'm seeing. The body looks exactly the same. The grip is the same. The handling is the same. It's in the same way minimalistic. It's photography pure. It's the essence of photography and capturing light. And that's exactly what I enjoy so much when I go out there for a shooting. So this is only my first review, and by the way, apologies for the background noise again. I'm sitting outside to catch the last daylight here. There is a lot of noise in the air coming from the neighbor's gardens. But, you know, the last thing I want to mention before I show some samples from my first few hours with the Leica M10R is to show you the most important button on that camera. And that's this button here. And that button was already on the M10P the most important button if you care for long exposures. And on the M10R it continues the story, but with a difference, namely that here, in contrast to the M10P, where you are limited to 120 plus seconds of exposure time, that's the longest you can get. Here you can go up to much longer exposure times, which isn't very nice. So somehow Leica was taken into account, I think, the wish from many users to have more than 2 minutes of exposure time. Still, it is dependent on the ISO setting. I'm going to show this in a moment, but it is a huge improvement compared to what we had before. So how is this working? There is, if you go to the shutter speed dial or the exposure time dial here, the so-called B mode, and it's the next stop after 8 seconds here. And then if you press and hold that button here, you get a sub menu. So let's do this. And now here you see, you can go up from 8 seconds to 12 seconds to 16 seconds. This is depending on ISO. So the hint from Leica here says the longest exposure time depends on the current ISO setting. So if we would go here to, let's say, an ISO value of, let's go here to an ISO value of 100 and push that button again, you see I can go up here now fairly well. So here at 120, 125 seconds, this was the end for the Leica M10P. But for the M10R, we can take 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 6, 8, 12, up to 16 minutes. And that's very, very nice. So there are cool options now for long exposure takings with this new camera here. And I think that's a good new feature. And that's the two main differences I personally see between the Leica M10P and the Leica M10R. If people have other things they notice which are different, drop me a comment. Maybe I overlooked it. As I said, I had time with this camera only for a few hours so far. But in my opinion, that's the two main differences. Longer exposure times here and a higher resolution sensor. So in the second half of the video, I'm going to show my samples from my first hands-on with the camera. I'm mainly interested in sharpness, clearly, because we are talking about a higher resolution in the upgrade. I'm interested in dynamic range, so shadows and highlights, how much can the sensor recover, and of course, higher ISO behavior and noise. The lens I was using for my shooting was the Summilux 35mm widest open aperture f1.4, and that's not known to be the sharpest lens in the Leica universe. So don't get me wrong, it's a sharp lens of course, even wide open, but not as sharp for instance as an Aposumicron 50mm f2.0. And the last remark I should make is this was not about getting the next Leica gallery master shot. It really was about testing those three properties of the new camera sensor and to see what this camera is made of. The first two shots I took right when I picked up the camera from the Leica store in Zurich. So this is in an apartment with friends around the corner. People are getting ready for dinner. And I wanted to test, of course, the camera right away when I had it in my hands. So indoor, the first two shots, ISO of 100 and an open aperture of f1.7. Second shot in that scene, same parameter as in the shot before. Again, a very clean image, looks very good. Clearly ISO 100 should not reveal a lot of noise. And I think in general, I was very lucky with that sunny evening here. My next scene was in the main train station in Zurich because I wanted to see people and also get different light conditions. Here the aperture was closed a little more to f2.4, but still low ISO and the same shutter speed, which makes sure that I do not have any fuzzy images here with a 35mm lens. So my next point of interest were the tracks. I like the way tracks and roads in general lead the observer's eye into an image. And here you see an amazing amount of sharpness. This is a 200% crop, what you are seeing here. I closed the aperture to f8.0 here and also had to increase the ISO value to 500. There's absolutely no difference in terms of noise when you compare it with the ISO 100 images you saw before. And there is an amazing amount of detail, clarity and sharpness in that image. And I think that provides a first good data point that Leica really improved that sensor from the M10P to the M10R, and the 40 megapixels really pay back. And the lens had absolutely no difficulties dealing with the much higher resolution in this shot here. So here's an image which on the left hand side is the original out of camera, completely overblown by highlights, super overexposed. On the right hand side, I just used the auto button on Lightroom. I had no time for post-processing and also wanted to present the images as original as possible coming out of the camera, of course, so people see what the quality is without a lot of tweaking afterwards. And the recovery in the highlights is very nice, in particular if you look at these red boxes now in this particular part of the image. You see on the left hand side hardly anything recognizable, on the right hand side nicely worked out. And I think this is a good indication for strong dynamic range of the new Leica M10R. In the park just around the corner from the main train station in Zurich, you also find a lot of plans where you can test the details. So here you see in the 200% crop what the details are actually on that image here. On the left hand side is the image as it came out of the camera. On the right hand side, again, no time for post-processing, just push the auto button on Lightroom. And clearly very nice what you get here in terms of sharpness, very nice what you also recover in the background out of the shadows, very nice light, and in general I think again a good indication for sharpness and dynamic range of the Leica M10R. Here another example on sharpness and details, so clearly not a prize winning photo, but if you zoom deeply into the plant here you see that little ladybug, which is amazing detail, not recognizable by the naked eye, and again a sign of strong sharpness. Here an example with a high ISO of 6400 and a very fast shutter speed and widest open aperture f1.4 and fast shutter speed to capture the raindrops here from that waterfall. Nice sharpness, nice clarity, and clearly a lot of reserves for post-processing, all in a good job from the sensor here. Here another image from inside, ISO 320, 1/125 again, aperture at f4, and again here we have a very, very nice image. Super sharp, super crisp, super clear, and the way the sensor is capturing light is very promising. And we are talking about the first firmware here. I think this will get even better in the future when they invest further work in the firmware and in the camera itself. Really nice, good image, very happy with the structure, the details, the light and the noise here. So after my test shots, I went back to the group of people and we went for dinner. And here you see nicely in the background the highlights and everything, but in the foreground I think that image is captured very nicely. And like always with Leica, it's that special Leica look which makes these cameras in combination with the M lenses so special. I like a lot that image and I think everything is just perfect in the way I wanted to have it. Good job by Leica M10R. Here a comparable image, same situation at dinner with friends, and again the background kind of overexposed, the foreground super crisp, super sharp. I think I will conclude my review here and come to a quick wrap up, but all in I hope these images were helpful to see what this camera is capable of doing. Let's wrap up this little review here. First of all, I did enjoy a lot shooting with the new Leica M10R. Next week I'll get my own unit. This one here has to go back to the Leica store for the opening of the store Monday morning, and I think that new sensor is terrific. I think the longer exposure time optionality is what people wished for, and in particular what I like a lot. And there will be more reviews coming in the next weeks when I will compare the M10R with the M10P, when I will look more into longer exposures. So stay tuned on my channel, do not miss content and things I'm posting on photography and tech. Thanks for watching, stay safe and healthy, and peace out.